Very good morning, students of class 10. Today we'll discuss history chapter 4, second phase of the Indian National Movement, led during 1905 to 1916. And this movement led mostly by the assertive nationalist. Here we'll discuss about Lord Curzon's controversial scheme of partition of Bengal and causes of partition of Bengal. So let's begin and go through the lesson for better understanding of this lesson. Lord Curzon's tenure of office as the Viceroy 1899 to 1905 was marked with controversies. One of his administrative measures that resulted in strong resentment was the partition of Bengal in 1905, which was considered as a concealed attack on Indian nationalism. Concealed attack on Indian nationalism means unseen attack, means with the brain they had planned attack which hidden attack also can be known. So let's know about the scheme of partition. Why this scheme they applied to partition Bengal? The presidency of Bengal was the most thickly populated province in British India. It comprised Bengal, Bihar, Odisha, Chotanagpur and some other remote area. Here Chotanagpur means the area of Jharkhand and small part of Chhattisgarh. So there were the large areas. Bengal means at present Bangladesh, at present West Bengal, Sikkim, Odisha, Bihar, these all areas comprises as a Bengal province. It had a huge population of over 80 million. On July 20, 1905, Lord Curzon announced the division of the province of Bengal into the following two provinces. Provinces means states, means areas. Means Lord Curzon wanted to divide Bengal into two provinces, means Eastern Bengal and Western Bengal. Eastern Bengal, mostly the Bengali speaking Muslims majority were, and Western Bengal non Bengali Hindu majority were. So here we'll discuss, see first the Bengal which included the western districts of Bengal proper, means now at present West Bengal, Bihar and Odisha, with a population of 54 million, Calcutta was made its capital. Second part, the Eastern Bengal and Assam, which comprised the eastern district of Bengal proper and Assam. Eastern district of Bengal proper means at present it is known Bangladesh, and Assam of the part of India. Now, with a population of 31 million, Dhaka was the capital of the new province of Eastern Bengal and Assam. The province of Eastern Bengal was dominated by Bengali Muslims, and the province of Bengal was dominated by non-Bengali populations with 31 million non-Bengali out of a total of 54 million. In both the province, the Hindu Bengali population became a minority. Means Hindu Bengali population became minority in both, even Eastern Bengal and in Western Bengal. The scheme of the partition of Bengal was implemented on October 16, 1905. So let's know the causes. What factor? What was the cause of the partition of Bengal? Why the British government governor Lord Curzon wanted to partition Bengal into two parts? The main motive for the partition of Bengal, according to the British ruler, was administrative necessity. They said that the province of Bengal was too big to be efficiently administered by a single provincial government. However, the officials who worked out the plan had other concealed motives. These included, means the British government given a reason that Bengal was a huge area and single British ruler, means administrative administration, it cannot be ruled in the entire area. So it can be partitioned, so it can be efficiently administered. The first cause given, Bengal was the nerve center of Indian nationalism at that time. So the British hoped to stop the rising tide of nationalism by partitioning Bengal. Means one reason was that they thought Bengal is a huge area and it was the nerve center of the Indian nationalism. Means all the movement led into the Bengal, and both Hindus and Muslims together contesting, becoming rebel against the British government, and they were criticizing or condemning the British government's rule. So they wanted to make a weak movement between two religions. So they had divided. Second cause was the population of the state was intended to curb Bengali influence by not only placing Bengalis under two administration, but by reducing them to a minority in Bengal itself. Means another was that instead Bengalis were united and that leading that all the movement. So they wanted to make the Hindu Bengali majority minority into the Bengal itself. So they had divided. Third cause was the partition was meant to foster division on the basis of religion. East Bengal would be predominantly a Muslim majority state, and West Bengal would have a Hindu majority. Means there was a purpose. They wanted to divide. The Eastern Bengal would be predominated by the Muslim majority, and the West Bengal must be the dominated by Hindu majority. The Indian nationalist clearly saw the design behind the partition and condemned it. They saw that it was a deliberate attempt to divide the Bengalis on religious and territorial grounds, and thereby disrupt and weaken nationalism in Bengal. Means Indian nationalists understood the purpose of British government, why they are partitioning. By partitioning, they try to weaken the Indian nationalism. They felt that administrative efficiency could have been better secured by separating Hindi-speaking Bihar and the Odia-speaking Odisha from the Bengali-speaking part of the province. Means the Indian nationalists seem that if they wanted to divide that Bengal, then must divide that Hindi-speaking Bihar and Odia-speaking Odisha from the Bengali-speaking part, means Bengal. Why they are dividing only the Bengali speaking. Why only dividing to the Bengal? They would have divided Bihar and Odisha from Bengal. Moreover, the manner in which the announcement of partition was made without any regard for the public opinion hurt the sentiments of sensitive Bengalis. Means it was completely a one kind of Hindi, you can say, sajis. Means they wanted to divide so that these Hindus and Muslims can divide and their policies may divide and rule may apply and they may get success to weaken the Indian nationalist to lead Indian national movement. Thank you.